People change. People change.
Smell of grass on a summer's day, heading out east to the Yorkshire Bays. I will miss you.
By introducing yourself.
Oh, hello, I'm Hesti Swati and I'm from Indonesia. I'm an English teacher, but now I'm a student because I'm joining this teacher training program. I started to be an English teacher in 2006, but actually I have already taught before that, so I really started teaching in 2003.
Mm-hmm.
I started to be as a English tutor.
Mm-hmm.
And I worked in an English course at that time. But then I moved to another English courses. And I had ever been as a substitute teacher in one of the public school in Pontianak in Indonesia.
Mm-hmm.
And then in 2006 there is this job vacancy by the government, and I applied, and thankfully it's my luck and I was chosen to be one.
Yeah.
And since 2006 I'm teaching in SMA Negeri 8 Pontianak. It is a public senior high school in Pontianak.
Mm-hmm.
Until now. I always thought that being able to speak English is very cool.
Mm-hmm.
And then I decided, like, okay, we'll learn that. And then, well, it seems that it fits me.
Yeah. So I've understood that Indonesia has certain some cultural aspects that for me as a teacher from Sweden was new to me. Some of them being singing national anthem, mm-hmm. Having a dress code, morning prayers, and so on. Could you give us a few examples of those, and what are your thoughts on them?
Well, we do wear uniform, and we have three kinds of uniform. Monday, Tuesday uniform, and it will be, since I'm teaching in senior high school, so it's white on top and gray at the bottom. And then for the Wednesday and Thursday, we wear batik, so it's a characteristic uniform.
Mm-hmm.
Each school has their own batik.
Okay.
And then for the Friday, they're wearing the Boy Scout,
mm-hmm.
Boy Scout uniform,
mm-hmm.
and that's for the public school. Every morning, we are recommended to sing a national anthem.
Mm-hmm.
Not only anthem, there is also another national song, so
mm-hmm.
two songs every morning.
Mm-hmm.
And then we also get the students used to pray before the class starts.
Mm-hmm.
So for the prayer, then yes, mostly it is done in a Muslim pray.
Yeah.
But then the Catholic students or the Buddhist and the Hindu students,
mm-hmm.
Are suggested to pray with their own pray.
Okay.
But because the number is not that many,
mm-hmm.
so mostly it will be the Muslim pray.
Mm-hmm.
So morning pray, and then national anthem,
mm-hmm.
and the national song.
Yeah.
And then we start the study, and then once we're done, we
mm-hmm.
finish the day by also singing another national song.
Mm-hmm.
So if you ask me my thought, then yeah, it is a good thing to do because it will put some nationalism on the student.
Mm-hmm.
Because we don't really have ethics subject.
Mm-hmm.
At least by doing so, we'll remind them that we are the member of this nation, and
mm-hmm.
make sure that we do our best.
Yeah.
And put our thoughts back.
Mm-hmm. What reactions do you get from the students? For example, uniform, for example, singing, and so on.
Well, it's in the rule that you're telling
me. You're just, okay, that's
okay.
It. Or the educational resources like in Indonesia?
I think with the facilities, government has tried their best,
mm-hmm.
to provide a very supportive
mm-hmm.
classroom or environment.
Mm-hmm.
They tried their best. And then we are also provided with e-books.
Yeah.
So sometimes, not really sometimes, for most subjects, you don't need to buy books because it's provided in the certain link and it's free.
Yeah.
You can just download it. The government sent the gift or provided us the guideline, and it is up to us what material that we're using. So they provided us with certain books, but if we feel like we want to use another book, then it's okay. And then they gave us some freedom to choose what method or techniques that you apply in the classroom, as long as it is following the guidelines.
Yeah.
Because they also mentioned the goals the students are supposed to, blah blah blah, and as long as it comes to that, then
yeah.
So I think it's a bit flexible.
Since you can then choose your own ways of teaching, you can choose the methods and so on. If you were trying to explain the way you teach, what makes you you? Or what are you like as a teacher?
We have this new curriculum implemented since 2013. So it has quite a change from the previous one. We really put the student centered, and we as a teacher just to help them as facilitators, so they're the one who's the main character in the study. So for me, I implemented the idea from doing, learning by doing, because for me, when they do things, then they will get the knowledge by themselves. It trigger them to study better. So the way I do it is I do some practical studying. I mean, like when I teach them, usually I will tell them that the study session will be divided into five activities.
Okay.
So the first one I will explain first, we will have discussions, and then we come to the activities. So I will give them listening practice, and then reading practice, and then writing, and then the last one will be speaking.
Yeah.
And for the listening and reading, of course, it will be provided by me, but for the writing and speaking, I will ask them to make something and then perform it. So for example, we learn about expressions, agree or disagree.
Yeah.
And then for the writing, I will ask them to make a dialogue, and then for speaking, they should perform it before class. Oh. Sometimes I record it too and show it to the principal or the other teachers when we have regular meeting.
And what are the students' reactions to you, for example, recording them or introducing these kind of methods to class?
Well, lucky for me, they don't mind. After that, I show it to them, and it's like.
And your among your colleagues then, are you, is this common that teachers at your school record students, or is that your thing?
They can if they want to, but probably they stress on the other techniques.
Do you discuss things like best practice or similar topics?
Sometimes if we have meeting. So we have this professional community, and it is not only in my school, so all English teacher in my hometown, so we make schedule, because it's also one of the government programs, so we do it. So we sit in a place and then have a discussion, presentation, something like that, and that's when we discuss about stuff.
Because now you're not teaching actively at the moment,
and
you've been part of competitions, you've been all around the world. I mean, you've taught in Indonesia, you've studied for a long time in the Netherlands, and now you're in Japan too. And I'm thinking that once when you return to Indonesia, you will continue to teach. And what kind of things have you learned throughout all of these journeys? Could you give an example?
First, trying to be really more friendly.
What does that mean? What does that mean? Could you please elaborate on being friendly?
Not to bully them. First, still about plan, and then context, and try to put more thoughts about. Well, because now I am a student, so. Well, when I even like before now, I'm still thinking like, what if I'm a student? Will I be able to answer these questions? But then, it's been some times, right? But now being really in the position of being a student,
yeah.
So I will put more thoughts on that and will really think more carefully about
okay.
that.
Some teachers whom I meet, they experience that teaching is something they feel is important to their person, or maybe it's even something that's at their core. Do you agree with that or disagree with it?
Yeah.
which one of them? Disagree,
yeah,
agree?
Well, I agree. I mean, like, teaching should be passion, because sometimes the welfare, can I say welfare? Or the salary or the environment is not that supportive, so and that if you don't put your passion and heart in it, then it will be a bit difficult to do. Well, actually not really about teaching, all work.
I stole this one from the speaking cafeteria that we've held lectures at. And what suggestions or tips or recommendations or any words of wisdom do you have for other teachers?
Keep your passion. Because again, everything, not only for teaching, but if you do not put your heart, your mind, and your passion, then it will be tiring.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, like, there's one time for me teaching is just a routine. And I don't really enjoy myself at that time. And it's really hard because, well, in my school, 1 year will be around 200-ish students.
Yeah.
So 200-ish personality, 200-ish problems. But because I don't really enjoy, I didn't really enjoy my teaching during that time, then I would feel like, oh, it's really burdensome. Like, I really can't wait with the holiday and all.
Yeah, yeah.
It's not enjoying. Not enjoyable.
Well, I can relate to that.
Yeah. So I think like, but when you put your heart into it and then don't forget your passion and everything is fine, I think. So keep it.
Smell of grass on a summer's day, heading out east to the Yorkshire Bays. I will miss you.